Oh, if they hire a woman, we won't be able to spit on the floor.
And we can't take off our pants when it gets real hot.
And we won't be able to pee in the drinking fountain.
Incorrect Tuesday with CJ and Johnny on Mix 106.
Baby,
I know. I'll take care of us. You know what? I think that there was a not careful now.
Kick your feet yourself, you two-time and crack whore.
Excuse me, you little belly something.
Oh, good comeback. You little belly something.
Jeez, Jim, you're not quite the same as you were yesterday.
It's what an improvement.
Yeah, I read the
you
same.
You know this, hey?
He must have went to the men's
room. I'm going to do.
He must have went to the men's room to read that one.
I just decided not to play that anymore because you pissed me off so much.
I've got something here.
Michael. Oh, yeah, right where? No, wait. Joe, bring over the things that make me see small, tiny things.
Jordan, woke up. I kill you.
Bring me over, Joe, the microscope. Jim says he has something here.
No, anyways, Michael Jackson's bride gave birth to a beautiful baby boy during a bizarre drama that shocked and frightened staffers at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center in Los Angeles on February 13th, one day short of Valentine's Day. Well,
Michael Jackson.
Jackson?
Michael Jackson is a very close friend of mine.
Michael Joseph Jackson Jr. was born at 1:17 a.m. February 13th to Debbie Rowe, 38, who married the superstar singer, married last November, in a secret ceremony in Australia. The newborn baby weighed in at a healthy 7 pounds, 10 ounces. And Debbie, the mother, spent most of her 12 hours of labor, well, I hope she was a mother, spent most of 12 hours of labor alone without Michael. But both Jackson and Debbie had their lawyers with them to discuss their parental rights. I'm so sick of reading about stuff about that guy. You have to take it
either. You know what? Let me tell you something. Michael is a dear, close friend of mine. And this crap that you read, I was going to say SH blank T, but I realized we were on the air, so I couldn't. This stuff you read in the newspapers, don't buy it. It's just a bunch of crap. It's not even true.
Oh, so why do you buy it?
If Michael
Jackson
paid, you
support those guys that buy that.
No, I don't. That is you. That is you. Not me. That's you. And if Michael Jackson were to come up to your doorstep, any one of you redneck
mother
puckers would welcome him in. And I'm sure you guys would give him a glass of wine or beer or whatever he wanted. I know you would.
You'd probably want to make sure your kids were tucked in bed with a
sitting back dog talking about him. And I think that is really stupid.
Yeah, you just say that because you just say that.
Stupid.
You say that because you don't have kids between the ages of 5 and 10. Otherwise, you might.
Now, wait a second. This is a man that supposedly has a mentality of a six-year-old, and let him alone.
The sexuality of a six-year-old.
Well, he has a mentality of a six-year-old.
No, he doesn't. Who said he has a mentality of a six-year-old?
I didn't even know about sex when I was six, did you?
Well, neither does he. He just knows he likes to rub young boys' penises.
So why would you be afraid to leave him with your neighbor's child?
Because he doesn't know about sex. He knows he doesn't know that he's not.
So what is he going to do? Molest them?
No,
he doesn't know what that's about.
Yeah, exactly. He doesn't know. That's why he does it. Because he doesn't know. He just knows it feels good.
It's Mr. Fox.
You call me Johnny.
Do you personally think that he actually molests children?
I don't know. I don't have enough facts about it.
Exactly. The same with the majority of the world today. We all judge before we think.
Well, exactly. I'm the judge, jury, and executioner. Don't mess with me. I'll screw you up big time. The fight is over and the road is long.
Falling asleep at the wheel again, baby. You're drifting over the line, yeah. Your hands are tight, but you're losing grip. Quickly fix me, can you read the signs? Thumbing your way to Vegas, dirty, and dreaming of the other side. Save your tears and laughter, because it doesn't matter what you find. It ain't pretty. It ain't pretty when the pretty leaves you. again, baby. You're drifting over the line, line. Your hands are tied, but you're losing grip quickly. Fix me, can you read the signs? Thumbing your way to Vegas, dirty, and dreaming like you're out of control. Save your tears and laughter, because this is the ride, and this is the show.
Listening to Johnny Fox and 8-Track Tuesday on Edmonton's Mix 106.
Are you a man who lives as a woman or a woman who lives as a man? If so, please call 1-800-96-JERRY and tell us about it.